First, it's very important to show the big international fashion names here at SCAD Fashion, and Guo Pei is of course one of those. And we are very proud to host her in her first solo exhibition in the States.
It's a fantastic exhibition. Guo Pei's clothing is just so beautiful. We tried to be restrained and hold back because the gown's so intricate that we really wanted to. Sometimes with clothing you have to tell a story, and in this case we didn't have to tell the story. The story is in the clothes. We just provided the backdrop in this special, very special show.
我觉得这个展览呢，真的我很满意，因为怎么说，他们用一种新的方式，用光线呢，来呈现了作品的另外一面。一直以来，我很想做这种静态展，因为我的作品，我觉得在T台上短暂的几分钟呢，其实只是给人们的一个印象，其实很多很多的细节，它是无法看到的。而静态展呢，就让人们能够近的距离去体会那些细节呢，其实是可以说是我更希望传递的，因为真的在细节中呢，你会有一份感动，因为他用了太多的爱和时间。我觉得这些创作这件作品的这个过程呢，其实是最珍贵的。
The first U.S. exhibition of her work, it was quite a coup, and so I was so interested to actually see the work itself, but then to be able to work on a book, it was very exciting.
Well, people are already reacting in a very positive way, and they are very surprised the amount of details, the historical elements, like Chinese mythology that is present in her designs, the amazing couture work. It's like incredible. She's more or less resurrecting all these techniques that were lost from Imperial China, and she's bringing it back. And it's very inspirational as well for our students. It's an incredible work.
嗯，是的，我觉得其实做时尚不仅做时尚需要爱，其实我觉得人们的生活中无处不在都应该有很多爱的分享、爱的表达、爱的存在。其实人和人之间的关系应该是爱的。嗯，所以其实我自己是一个喜欢热爱一切的人，我也愿意用爱分享。 刚好我是个设计师，所以我很想用作品的设计，来分享这份温暖和爱。嗯，爱是最人类来说最最重要的一部分。我觉得现在的社会很多人不太懂爱，而渐渐的，这个社会也是在失去爱。嗯，我也很想用作品的那份爱，用我真诚的爱的投入，来与人们分享爱的重要，爱的温暖。
It's so much more than just couture. That's theater, there's history that she's bringing back. The historical references that she includes in her work are magnificent. Be it, you know, mythology from Chinese heritage, ancient traditions that are no longer you know, mass used. It's definitely beyond just fashion.
The handwork, the amount of detail, the attention to detail, so intricate, so beautiful. It's so ethereal. I was honored to just be able to see that.
Looking at the detail and the beading and how long it takes, and that's not something you see anymore. And I really think that that artisan kind of craft that she has, I think that's something that we need to see more of today in modern fashion.
年轻人都非常希望自己能够将来很有名、很成功，包括设计师也是这样。其实我觉得，成功、有名、有钱，其实它不应该成为你的目的，它不是你的目的。其实热爱才是你激发你这个激情啊、创作力的一种方式，或者是更重要的一个部分。
如果年轻人把出名作为了他的目的，其实恰恰让他很出名，或者他恰恰是会采用很多其他的方式啊。我觉得这个社会其实应该更多唤醒人们的那份内心的爱。有爱的话，你可能就不那么在乎短暂的这个失去，或者不太在乎你短暂的这种艰苦啊坚持。你可以付出，甚至你可以奉献。我觉得年轻人他们可能不是很懂得什么叫真正的奉献。如果你做一位设计师，你只是为了出名，你只是为了所谓的成功获得利益的话，其实那个过程会更加的痛苦。如果你有一天你觉得你选择设计是因为你的爱，是因为你要创作美好与人分享，是因为你要为这个社会为人类留下点什么，是因为你要帮助别人，是因为你的奉献的时候，他才会快乐和幸福。所以其实我想用我的作品来跟大家告诉这些学生，告诉年轻的设计师这一切。因为这些作品中他会看不到你，他会看不到那么多的所谓的他们的获得，我觉得他看不到。甚至说他也许郭培做这些作品慢慢有了名气，但在做这个作品之前或这个过程中，我没有这一切，但是我也愿意奉献。所以很，因为什么别人知道了你的影响力是建于什么之上的。如果你的影响力是帮助别人而建立的，或者你的名声是因为你帮助了人类和社会而建立的，我觉得这样的结果是他们应该追求的。
And fashion, the Chinese people also love the beauty, and the people looking for the beauty, working for the beauty. I think beauty in everywhere in the life. Our government also encourages the beauty and creation. I think the art and the design is not only shows and design, also is culture exchange to make the people understand each other, to make people to establish a bridge between US and China, particularly in the southern part of the United States with China.
是的，因为中国呢，时尚发展的时间非常的短。我们在短短的20多年中呢，我们从零开始，从一切没有开始。其实我们虽然成在很多西方人眼里，我们是一个很大的一个加工啊制造的一个国家，但是这是我们学习的过程。就是因为我们要通过这样的过程呢，不断的去学到很多的知识甚至技能。如果说中国呢从这个制造能够走向创造的话，我觉得它的制造的这个过程是必不可少的。所以渐渐的我们中国可能慢慢出现了很多的创造，就是包括我们自己的设计呀，我们自己的文化呀，以及我们像我这样的设计师啊，当然我觉得我只是代表其中的一个代表。那么就它已经呈现出我们中国已经逐渐的走向了一种自立啊，就是我们的文化自信，我们的文化自信，我们的艺术方方面面，我们的民族自信啊，建立在这种基础上，我们开始自立。所以我觉得这是必须经历的过程。